Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm going to be doing a review of the Sedona Lace 168 Pro Full Color 2nd Edition Palette. And I swear that is the longest makeup palette name ever. And this is what it looks like. If you follow me on Instagram, then you've seen me post a couple of pictures of this palette and the looks that I did with this one. Go ahead and check that out. That is linked in the description box. And just while you're at it, follow me too. It comes in two. Because you have 168 eyeshadows in total, and it looks like this. For close-ups of the palette itself and the eyeshadows, go to my blog. And also, if I missed anything in this video, you will find the information that you will need on there, and you can also comment below if you have any questions, as well as my blog post. So let's start with the service. The service was really smooth sailing. I chose the palette among all the palettes that they had. Excuse me if I say palettes a bajillion times in this video, but among the palettes that were available on the site, I was quite confused which one to get, and I decided to get this one mainly because they have really unique eyeshadows. They have eyeshadows that are mixed. Like, this one is a lime with neon orange, and then the other one, this one is like a magenta with blue, and we have here like an orange with like pink specks on it, and I thought that was really interesting. I've never encountered eyeshadows that are not baked that look like that. It was placed in this really big box with lots of peanuts, and it was rolled in this really thick bubble wrap, which made sure that the eyeshadow pans were not going anywhere and you would not end up with broken eyeshadows on your doorstep. And that was really great because that showed a lot of effort on Sedona Lace's part, and they're actually the first company that has these kind of palettes that actually wrapped each pan, or not pan, but each like palette in plastic, and that ensures that the pans don't go anywhere. And I thought that was really great because one of the main issues that you will have to encounter, or not have to, but you can encounter when you get palettes on this like this online, is when they are delivered, they are mishandled, and like I said, you will end up with broken eyeshadows and such. So I thought that was really great. They made sure that the palette is durable and all that, so that's plus points. The second thing that I really like about this is that they have amazing selections of colors. They have super bright, like almost neon. I think they also, this one is a true neon pink. I tried it, I swatched it. You will see it on my blog because I took a photo of it. It is like legit neon, and it's almost like, I don't know, it's almost like the Sugar Pill eyeshadows, if you're familiar with that, and they're even better if you have like a really opaque white base underneath before you apply the colorful eyeshadows. And I love that even though they're like mostly colorful, bright, bold eyeshadows, they also included shimmery neutrals, shimmery satin and matte neutrals on there. So if you're the type of person who wants to use a palette with both like really interesting neutrals and bold eyeshadows, then this is the palette to get. If you're an aspiring makeup artist, if you're a beginner who just wants to play around with makeup, then definitely consider the 168 Second Edition palette, because it's, I love this palette. I honestly do, and I'm not just saying that, I really do. And actually, this look that I have on right now was created with this palette. This eyeshadow is gorgeous. It's like a really warm, rust, bright orange, and it's just so easy to blend. The eyeshadows, the consistency of them are creamy, powdery, you know, like Wet n Wild eyeshadows, if you're familiar with how they feel when you apply them, that's how they apply. And another thing that I wanted to mention is that if you want the colors to really pop, use a really white opaque base. And then if you just want the true color, just use the Stick It To Em eyeshadow primer from Sedona Lace. It's $9.95. You can find it on their website, and it comes in this really huge tube that will last you forever. I used that same eye primer with the BH Cosmetics 28 Neutral Palette, and it just made the eyeshadows really pop and really kind of it made its true color appear on my lids, and I thought that was really awesome. It has great pigmentation. Oh, the only thing that I would like to mention that I'm not very happy with, well, considering that you're only paying for that amount, like you're only paying like around $30 for like a lot of eyeshadows, it doesn't last as long. Well, I would expect high-end eyeshadows to really last and really have the same features that this eyeshadow palette has, but you know, if you consider like high-end eyeshadows and then you get 168 eyeshadows that has pretty much the same features apart from it lasting really long, which you can definitely fix with a really good base, a really good primer, you know, the price is really, the price difference is huge. So I like this palette. If you want a more detailed review, go to my blog. I will just show you a few clips of me taking a quick close-up of the palette itself and the eyeshadows and all that stuff for swatches. Go to my blog once again. And thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video. I hope that this was helpful. If you're on the lookout for a really nice like palette with colorful bold colors and really nice shimmery metallic neutrals, then this is the palette for you, the Sedona Lace 168 Pro Full Color Second Edition Palette. And if you're not interested in this one, go ahead and check out the other palettes that Sedona Lace has. Oh yeah, if you're wondering, if you want a tutorial, I would try to do that. I just wanted to get this out right now, and I felt like if I were to do a tutorial on this look right now with my lens, it would be a waste of time because I wouldn't have the quality of video that I would want and that you deserve to watch. So if you do like this look, I will do a photo tutorial on my Instagram, so go ahead and follow me there. And don't forget to check out my Facebook, my Pinterest, and all my social media in the description box. Once again, all the links and all the information that you want to know will be found on my blog as well as the description box. Thank you again for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye! You.